the Independent People's Party says it will set up a $10 billion jobs fund to provide startup capital to young Ghanaians who want to go into entrepreneurship. The party says it is committed to making investments to help all Ghanaians reach their highest potential. And this afternoon, I do have in the studio the presidential candidate for the Independent People's Party, Kofi Agbalu. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Wendy.
And thanks for your time here.
Thanks.
Now, before we even go straight to our interview, we just aired a story about audited accounts in the EC stating that some political parties haven't brought theirs to the EC. Have you done yours?
Oh, yes, we have done ours. Because I'm even surprised to see that only one political party have done 2015. We submitted 2012, 2013, 2014, 2015. Mm. We've done all that. So we've submitted it to the EC. So I'm even surprised to see that they are recorded only one political party. Maybe they meant IPP.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you're confident that that has been done?
Oh, yes. Yes, we've done that.
Now, again, your party is saying that it's committed to making investments to help all Ghanaians reach their highest potential. And IPP has a vision to connect to communities and create jobs through affordable and reliable transport system that works. And you promise to connect citizens to the rest of the world through a free Wi-Fi hotspot in libraries and public open spaces with free access and free data for everyone to be online. Now, first of all, let's move to, before we talk about the free Wi-Fi project, let's look at the jobs you're going to create. And initially, I did read that your party says it will set up a $10 billion job fund to provide startup capital to young Ghanaians who want to go into entrepreneurship. Well, two questions for you. What informed that decision? And already, if you should come to power in 2016, if you should win that elections, we already have several projects and funds that are available to young people who are interested in moving into entrepreneurship. What happens to those projects?
Yeah, you see, what we intend to do is different. We want to make sure every Ghanaian, no matter your political color. At the moment, all the projects there are meant for political party people.
There are some people who are not associated with parties but are still benefiting from them.
Yeah, how many are there? You see, if you don't have a political color, there are certain things you will never get.
And you have proof that these people are related to the parties, as how come they are benefiting from them?
Yeah, I don't know whether you've noticed this in Ghana here, whereby you go to, somebody sees you maybe with other political opponent, even when you are in the same place eating or something like that, they tag you. Are you okay? So even some people even find difficult to go to even to the ministries. The ministry is supposed to be there for every Ghanaian.
Now, I'm sure if you walk into the ministry, they won't ask you if you belong to party A or B.
No, let's see if you see me at maybe with Nana Akufo-Addo or maybe with John Mahama or maybe Pakua Sindum. The conclusion is, oh, the guy is flirting, this kind of stuff. Now, that's what's happening.
How true could that be?
Oh, it is. That is going on. You heard recently that John Boadu was accused.
Let's focus on your project, which is very critical. The reason why
our project is that we want to make sure we empower Ghanaians. We want every Ghanaian, especially those from our universities and polytechnics, to start their own businesses and create jobs. Because we have the conviction that if you are able to create maybe 200,000 entrepreneurs, they will in turn employ about 10 million people. So you create jobs and you cover the massive unemployment that we have at the moment. We have a lot of guys coming from universities with that hope. And IPP, we want to give them hope. So we want to make sure monies are available. If you want to start your business, we ask you, we put mentors there for you so that they take you through. I mean, so that they will help you. So whatever money you will need to start that business. So for us, you'll be able to convince us that that business will work and at the same time, it will create jobs for other people. We will support you financially.
So what happens to the old projects before we talk about where you're going to get the funding from?
Yeah.
What happens to the old projects?
If there are other projects, yeah, we put them in. We absorb those projects.
Why wouldn't you let them work and see them work? What happens to continuity?
Because
over the years, we've seen governments start projects, others continue, others don't, because they feel it's not their party's project. And this is an example of what you're talking about here. What happens to all those monies have been invested over the years into those projects, and then you come up and you start another one altogether?
No,
again.
I'm not starting another one altogether. I'm just improving on what I'm coming to meet.
But it's a totally new project.
Yeah, it's not, because I'm making sure, giving money to you to start your own business. I mean, it's normal. It's anywhere in the world. If you go to Europe, if you go to America, the government is there to support its citizens to make sure they...
But in those places, there's continuity.
Yes, well, that's exactly what I'm coming to do. Because I'm in to make sure, if you're a young man, you have ideas, you have good ideas to create jobs. I've got to support you. It's about support. So I want Ghanaians, especially the young men and women, to understand that our government, IPP, we are ready to support them to go every length. If we have to help you, like sports, for instance, if we have to invest money, $600 million in sports to create about, let's say, 5 billion market, we will do that. Because if you go to the United States, for example, the sports industry is $216 billion every year. So what are we waiting for? We have to take advantage of this. Make sure we grow talents, we develop talents, but it requires money, it requires commitment. So IPP, what we want to assure Ghanaians is that we are ready to make sure everybody survive, everybody succeeds.
Now, you said you're going to absorb the old ones. Are they going to work hand in hand, or how will you do it?
Oh, we just improve on what is there. We just
while
improve.
The new one is still running.
You see, if like currently they have what they call years. Mm-hmm. Yeah, are you okay? Mm-hmm. So we will make sure this year's, which is about 10 million, 10 million cities. Mm-hmm. Now, 10 million is peanut. You understand? If you are serious, you want to create jobs, 10 million is 10 million cities is peanut. Mm-hmm. Are you okay? So we want to turn into $10 billion project.
So fund. You give all that money to YES? Is that what
yes,
you're saying?
That's exactly what
so
we want
what
to
happens
do.
To the other projects? That's what I mean.
Which other projects?
Because there are several other projects which unless help.
Unless you give me money.
We have incubation centers here in the country
yeah.
where people who have startups, especially ooh. IT-related, go to. They have their mentorship programs that you've even touched on. So yeah. the question I'm asking is that, how are you going to put
yes, all
these
things
together?
No, all these things are there, and we have to improve on them. I'm not going to, because we've not said anywhere that we're going to stop okay. All those things. What we are saying is that we are setting up a $10 billion job
okay.
fund. The fund is to help everyone who wants to go into business to start their own business, have the financial muscles to okay. do something.
Now, before we touch on the money also, you've promised Ghanaians that you will provide free internet projects, and specifically where... We just touched on some areas, including libraries.
Yeah.
Have you done an estimate of that project, and how, where are you getting the funding from? If I talk about funding, let's look at the $10 million project mm-hmm. and then also that of the internet project.
Yeah.
But first of all, let's touch on the cost of the internet project.
Yeah, you see, you need to understand first where we are going before you talk about cost. Are you okay? Because if I mention $5 billion, $2 billion, what is that $2 billion for? Are you okay? What we are saying is that we are going to make sure all the libraries, the public libraries, yeah, we have free access to Wi-Fi. If you on the buses, we should have free Wi-Fi. If you are traveling from here to Tamale, the STC and the other buses, we have to make sure we have free Wi-Fi. All is to help create wealth. All is to help improve the economy.
So it means that, Asana, you don't have an estimated cost.
No, I'm coming. Somebody, I can just mention the figure.
No, but without, if I'm
no,
asking, because
you understand where I'm coming from, but the viewer, the listener, doesn't know what this guy is talking about.
Because of time, I'm asking because if you want to come to power, by yeah. now you should have done all your checks what exactly you're looking at.
We are investing $1 billion in that.
$1 billion.
$1 billion.
Okay, and then where are you getting the funding from? What? How are you going to work on the funding for the internet project and also the $10 billion job project you're looking at?
We have so many ways of creating capital. Are you okay? It can come in a form of equity. It can come in a form of debt. These two. So in the debt, you have a lot of breakdowns. You have what we call supplier credit. So I can ask you to give me something and then I'll pay later. Supply me the goods and I'll pay you later. Are you okay? So these are some of the stuff that we're talking about. Now, if we are setting up $10 billion, now, Ghana here, we have people like you who are working, you are making good money, and you have the money sitting in the bank, and the money's not working for you. So we want to help you, people like you, about a million of you, bring $500, it's $500 million. Are you okay? Mm-hmm. And we will help you to start up a company that you are a shareholder in that company.
Okay. Now, quickly, let me just cut you in then. One of the very critical issues is that you kicked against the IPP. That's IPP, your party, kicked against the new register. And now also there are calls for some parties that the issue should undertake verification. What do you make of these concerns?
Yeah, about you see, the reason why we say we don't need any new register is simple. At the moment, if you are to do a new register, what will change? Nothing will change. Because we know this country, we don't have proper identification. We don't have proper address system. So what we are saying is that before we do anything of such, we should first do the right thing, build the foundation. Let's get all the houses registered. Let's get all the rules and alleys named. And then we know that this person is living here, is living there. And then we have to allocate social security numbers to everybody to serve as de facto ID.
That point's well made. But
when that is done, then we can register new people, or we can do a fresh register.
What about the verification bits, which is becoming a total concern for some Ghanaians also, and even some political parties?
What I'm asking the EC to do is that we should try as much as possible to encourage Ghanaians, those who have registered, to go back and verify whether compulsory verification, that they should go and verify whether their name is there before the 2016 election.
Okay.
Is what?
Uh-huh. Thank you very much for your time, Kofi Akpaloo. He is the presidential candidate for the Independent People's Party. You're still watching MiddayLive.